They're turning American life into a zero-sum game, where for one to win, another must lose.
Muscle cars and redheads. That was Congressman Joe Kennedy III delivering part of the official Democratic rebuttal to the president's State of the Union, blaming the Trump administration for creating a more divisive country. I want to bring back MSNBC contributor and my dear friend, Republican strategist Steve Schmidt. What's your reaction to Joe Kennedy's points? Do you agree that American life has become a zero-sum game?
Well, there's no question, Stephanie, that our politics has become extremely dysfunctional and that we stand in 2018, 50 years from the most divisive year in American history since the Civil War, 1968. We're repeating this cycle. We live in a very divisive time, the most divisive in 50 years, and the President of the United States bears a large measure of responsibility for that in our national life.
All right, something stuck out to me after the response. Axios's Jonathan Swan tweeted this from a GOP source. Quote, as a Republican, I love how at the end of the day, after all their years of crap about identity politics, Democrats picked a white dude from one of the most privileged families in America to do the response. I want you to share your thoughts because for me it stood out that you can still be a white guy with a privileged background to care about the underprivileged, to care about equality. The forefathers of our country might have been white guys, but it doesn't mean you can't care and do for others.
I'm not sure I come up with the same evaluation of the congressman that unnamed strategist does. 37 years old, he's going to have a big future in the Democratic Party. He's viewed uniformly as a rising star in that party. There's another young congressman in a adjacent district, Seth Moulton, a combat Marine veteran. And Joe Kennedy is one of the future faces of the Democratic Party. It's a party that is skewing older in its representation in the Congress, in the House, and the Senate. But we're going to get to know some of these young Democratic stars nationally over the course of the next year or so, and he's one of them. And lastly, when you look at the horrid history of people who have given these responses, from Bobby Jindal to Marco Rubio, that was about as good a response as we've seen in recent years from someone in the opposite party responding to one of these states of the union.
But the Democrats have their message because we saw a variety of responses, whether it was Democrats wearing black or Joe Manchin sort of standing up and clapping, and even the responses seem different. So do Democrats know what their message is yet?
No, they don't, but I'm not sure they need to have one for 2018. They have a favorable map, and it seems to me that there's one question on the ballot, and that question increasingly is, do you want to put a check on President Trump by putting the Democrats in charge of one or both houses of the Congress? I think that's the only issue that's going to matter in the ballot in 2018, what's increasingly looking like a nationalized election, a real referendum on this president's performance.
Well, the president would argue that the tide is turning for the Americans. I want you to listen to this.
This, in fact, is our new American moment. There has never been a better time to start living the American dream.
What does the new American moment entail? Because people want to capitalize on that. And even in the president's first year, those who elected him are not the same people as those who have benefited. Remember after he won, when he snuck out of Trump Tower and went to the 21 Club, he walked in, looked at the dining room and said, I'm gonna cut your taxes. And he did cut the taxes of the wealthy. He is now flanked by CEOs and he wasn't on the campaign trail. So when he talks about the new American moment, who exactly is it for?
I'm not sure, Steph. I do know this, that 44% of the country doesn't have $400 in available cash for an emergency. 67% have less than $1,000 in savings. We have more payday lenders in America than we do Starbucks. And we have 10 million people that can't access the banking system. And so for that percentage of the population living in places that are riddled with opioid addiction, where there is a lot of problems in the country, it doesn't matter if the Dow Jones average is $45,000. They're not participating in the economy that Donald Trump is describing, and none of his policies have had the effect of solving what's increasingly the number one economic and political problem in the country, which is stagnant wages for the middle class, which is driving tremendous political instability in the country.
Income inequality plagues this nation, and the problem rages on. Steve Schmidt, thank you so much always for your extraordinary insight.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.